वेरी गुड मॉर्निंग टू ऑल माय डियर स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू सेंट एंजल्स पब्लिक स्कूल बागपत ऑनलाइन इकोनॉमिक्स क्लासेस। एज यू नो दैट वी आर वर्किंग फ्रॉम अवर होम, सो माय डियर स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अगेन चैप्टर नंबर 6 मींस कांसेप्ट ऑफ कॉस्ट, एंड टुडे वी विल डिस्कस मींस रिलेशनशिप बिटवीन टीसी टीएफसी एंड टीबीसी, बिकॉज यू नो दैट इन माय प्रीवियस वीडियो वी हैव डिस्कस्ड what do you mean by total cost, total fixed cost and total variable cost with the help of diagram, but today means we are going to discuss relationship between TC, TFC and TBC. Now we will discuss relationship between TC, TFC and TBC with the help of this diagram, with the help of this diagram. See, first of all, TC curve is the summation of TFC and TBC curve. TC curve is the summation of TFC and TBC curve. See, you know that TC is equal to TFC plus TBC. TC is equal to TFC plus TBC. So we can say on behalf of this formula, TC curve is the summation of TFC and TBC curve. TBC and TFC curve. I hope this is clear. See, The change in TC curve is entirely due to TBC and TFC remains constant. So both TFC and TBC are inversely S-shaped due to law variable proportion. See, now you know that TFC remains constant. At all levels of output means whether output is zero or large and small, whether output is large, small or and even zero, but TFC remains constant at all levels of output. See, now but TBC changes with change in the level of output. What does it mean? It means that suppose output is zero, TBC will be zero. Suppose output increases, then TBC will increase, and output decreases means TBC will decrease. So I hope all of you have understood means TBC changes with the change in the level of output, but TFC remains constant at all levels of output. So we can say like this, the change in TC entirely due to TBC, not because of TFC. See, so we can say that the change in TC entirely due to TBC. It means, you know that TBC is inversely S-shaped, so TC will be inversely S-shaped, because the change in TC entirely due to change in TBC. So I hope all of you have understood means we can say like this, TC and TBC curve both are inversely S-shaped. So I hope it is clear. See, at zero level of output, see, output level will be zero at here. See, means output will be zero here. So at zero level of output, TFC and TC curve start from the same point above the origin. See, you know that at zero level of output, TC will be zero. It means TC is equal to TFC at zero level of output, because TBC will be zero at zero level of output. So I hope all of you have understood, at zero level of output, TFC and TC curve start from the same point, which is above the origin. So I hope this point is also clear. See, fourth point, the vertical distance between TC and TFC. See, vertical distance between TC and TFC increases because you know that, see, you know that output increases, TVC will also increase. Suppose output increases, TVC will increase. It means that the gap between TC and TFC, the gap between vertical distance between, see, vertical distance means gap between TC and TFC increases because output increases, TVC also increases. So we can say like this, the vertical distance between TC and TFC increases due to rise in TVC with rise in output. So I hope fourth point is also clear. See, fifth point, TC and TVC curves are parallel to each other. TC and TVC curves are parallel to each other because TFC remains same at all levels of output. So I hope it is clear. Now after this we will discuss this relationship with the help of schedule, but please try to understand here relationship between TC, TFC, TVC with the help of this diagram. See, TFC, TVC and TC can be calculated with the help of each other. TC, TVC and TFC can be calculated with the help of each other. See, you know that now, see, TC is equal to TFC plus TVC. Suppose if you want to calculate value of TFC, then formula will be TC minus TVC. And suppose if you want to calculate TVC, then formula will be TC minus TFC. So I hope it is clear. So please pause the video and note down this. Now, after this means with the help of diagram, we will discuss this relationship with the help of schedule, see here. But first of all, please try to learn how will you make a table of TC, TFC and TVC. See, first of all, take output in units, then after TFC in rupees, then after TVC in rupees and TC in rupees also. See, take any value of output, but start from 0. 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Now, value of output up to, I'm taking here value of output up to 7. Now, TFC. See, TFC remains same at all levels of output. So, you can take any value. See, I'm taking here 10. TFC remains constant at all levels of output. See, but you know that when output is 0, then TVC will be 0. Then see, output increases, TVC increases, TVC also increases. See, take 10. You can take any value. Then after 18. And you can take 24. Then 31. Then you can take 40. And then you can take 50. And you can take 55. See, but please listen carefully. How will you take value of TVC? First of all, when output is 0, TVC is 0. See, but you will increase value of TVC, but initially decreasing rate, then finally increasing rate. See, TC, TVC increasing, TVC is increasing at a decreasing rate. See here, Now you can take 65. Then 15. See, first of all, see, TVC increasing, TVC, you can say TVC increases at a decreasing rate, at a decreasing rate, and finally at a increasing rate. So first of all, you will take, I see, means output is zero, TVC will be TVC will be zero. Output increases, TVC increases. But first of all, you will increase TVC at a decreasing rate, then at a then at an increasing rate. See, 0 to 10, 10, 10 to 18, 18 by the rate of 8, and 18 to 24 with the rate of 6, 24 to 31 with the rate of 7. Then after, see, rate is increasing here. So I hope all of you have understood how will you make, or you can say how will you take value of TVC. Now TC is equal to TFC plus TVC, so add both these values. 10, 20, 28, 34, 41, 50, 60 and 75. See, TC curve is the summation of TFC and TVC curve. This is clear. The change in TC curve, the change in TC curve entirely due to TVC. See, 8, TVC increases with 8, then after, sorry, with 10, then after 8, TEC also 8, and by 6, and by 6, by 7, by 7, by 9, by 9, by 10, by 10, by 15, by 15. See, the change in TC curve, the change in TC curve due to TVC, due to TVC, due to TVC, and TVC are inversely S-shaped due to law variable proportion. Because you know that means the change in TC entirely due to change in TVC. So TVC curve is inversely S-shaped. It means TC curve will be inversely S-shaped. And see, TFC remains constant. TFC remains constant. TFC remains constant. It means TFC will not affect TC. TFC will not affect TC. TC will not affect TC. Because see, जो change हो रहा है TC में, वो किसकी value के equal change हो रहा है? TVC. See, 10, 8, 6, 7, यानी TC में जो change लाता है, वो कौन लाता है? TVC लाता है. TFC का कोई role नहीं होता. तो जैसे TVC curve होगा, ऐसा ही TC curve होगा. सीधी सी बात है. तो यहाँ पे हमने क्या लिखा है? TS are inversely S-shaped due to log variable proportion. See, at zero level of output, at zero level of output, TFC and TC, value of TFC and TC will be equal. Value of TFC and TC means TFC is equal to TC. At zero level of output, TFC is equal to TC. TFC is equal to TC. So both curve will be start from same point above the origin. Means when at zero level of output, TFC is equal to TC, it means TFC and TC curve will start from the same point, which is above the origin. The vertical distance, and now there is no need to explain this definition, this point with the help of this table. It is so you can say it can be understand with the help of diagram. See, TFC, TVC and TC can be calculated with the help of each other. Now it is also clear, TC is equal to TFC plus TVC. And suppose if you want to calculate, TFC is equal to TC minus TVC, and TVC is equal to TC minus TFC. So see here, now all these relationship between TC, TFC and TVC, I hope all of you have understood with the help of table and diagram. So please pause the video and note down this. Now you know that we have discussed TC, TFC and TVC. Now again means or you can say like this, we have discussed the relationship between TC, TFC and TVC with the help of diagram and schedule. But means today we will discuss AFC, ABC, AC. Means we are going to discuss AFC, ABC and AC. See, first of all we will discuss AFC. Average fixed cost. Average fixed cost. What is the definition of this? It refers to per unit fixed cost of production. Per unit fixed cost of production. It refers to per unit fixed cost of production. This is the definition of AFC. And what is the formula of AFC? AFC is equal to TFC divided by Q. See, TFC divided by Q. TFC and divided by level of output. Quantity of output. You can select quantity of output, levels of output. See, now